all seen lightning outside, but when you see it from 4 meters, it's a completely different experience. We would test sometimes for millions of volts of lightning, and you would see a good 4 meter lightning bolt. That's very impressive. There's not a lot of places within the world that can actually do this kind of thing, and I think this is going to be quite a revelation in terms of where we're coming from. My name is Dr. Vidhi Pishpati. I work here at the High Voltage Lab at University of Manchester. It's the UK's largest high voltage lab for any university, and we are able to test anything that goes onto the electrical grid here. Most of the time we're testing electrical equipment that's either been on the network or might go on the network. To understand how equipment ages, we try and mimic the conditions that you see outside. That could be rain, that could be wind, that could be long-term aging. The large pylons you see on the highway are around 400,000 volts. Now, within this lab, we can actually mimic those voltages. Sometimes we'll push it a bit further as well. We might hit it with lightning a couple of times, and we'll try and see if we can predict failure before it happens. If the failure happens, you've got a blackout. The last thing you want is a blackout in a big city. You have hospitals, houses, industry being connected. So it's actually vital to be able to monitor these even before they happen. Now, you don't want to be inside when there's a lightning bolt, because the last thing you want to do is touch something that's a high voltage, which could be fatal. It's better for us to stay in this control room. Engineers of today will be deciding the network in the next 50, 60 years. I see the future network as an electrical household, is what I'd like to call it. We're all having renewables connected to our houses, so we could have a solar panel, we could have a wind turbine. All of us could become a generating station in the future. If you think you have an electrical car and you're plugging it onto the network, on a day when you don't use it, you might be able to actually give that energy to the network. Fossil fuels are being cut down, rightly so. We have to find better ways of generating power. We have to find better ways of using power, which is key. The questions are immense, and this lab will still fit into that big question. It's vital that we understand, each and every one of us, in our households, how we use electricity and how it is going to impact our future.